Hello everyone, welcome to my new channel English Only Zone. I am Akanksha Sharma. We will be learning different rules of English grammar on this channel. We will also be studying chapters of Treasure Trove, a book prescribed by ICSE board for classes 9th and 10th. So today we will be learning nouns. So let's get started. First we will study about the definition and then we will move on to different types of nouns. A noun is the name of a person, place, animal or a thing. Examples can be a person, example Ram, any animal such as lion, a place such as Delhi. So the other name of noun is naming words. Nouns are also known as naming words. We call a thing by its name. So whatever name we give to things, animals or persons around us, we call that name a noun. Now let's study different types of nouns. Basically there are 5 different types of nouns. These are proper noun, common noun, collective noun, abstract noun and material noun. Now let's study these 5 types one by one. We will start with proper noun first. The definition of proper noun is: a proper noun is the particular name given to a thing. It can be the name of a boy, an animal, a company, a team, etc. It means, किसी भी चीज का खास नाम proper noun कहलाता है. Example, a particular name of a boy, it can be Rohan, Soham, etc. A particular name of an animal, it can be Tom, Kitty, Jerry, Tuffy, etc. The name of a company also comes under the category of proper noun. For example, Idea, Tata, Rolex, etc. There are 2 important points which are to be noted in proper nouns. Those are, a proper noun always starts with a capital letter. For example, R in Rahul should be capital, N and D in New Delhi should be capital, C in Cello, R in Reliance, M and I in Mumbai Indians. So a proper noun always starts with a capital letter. No article is supposed to be written before proper noun. This is the other important point. It means articles such as a, an or the should not be written before proper noun. A proper noun should be written separately alone. Now let's study common noun. A common noun is the name given in common or general to any person or thing. It means it is a general name given to something or person which is of same kind. Now like proper noun, in common noun also there are 2 points to be noted. Those are, a common noun always starts with a small letter. For example, C in computer, P in pen, W in woman, C in city, etc. Now the second point is the articles such as a, an or the. In these articles, any article should be compulsorily written before proper common noun. So some articles such as a, an or the should be compulsorily written before a common noun. For example, I bought a pen from the market. So in the sentence, pen and market are common noun. So article a is written before pen and the is written before market. In the second sentence, the monkeys on the tree are eating apples. So the monkeys on the tree are eating apples. In this sentence, the monkeys. Monkeys is a common noun. So the is written before monkeys and the tree is also a common noun. So the is written before tree also. Now let's move on to material noun. A material noun is the grammatical term given to any material or substance with which a thing is made of. किसी भी चीज को बनाने के लिए जो material use होता है उस सब्सटेंस को हम मटेरियल नाउन की कैटेगरी में रखते हैं. लाइक वी यूज gold or silver to make jewelry. So in this and so gold and silver can be termed under the category of material noun. We use cotton or wool to make clothes. So cotton and wool are material noun. Likewise, plastic also, we use plastic to make different things. So plastic also comes under the category of material noun. Similarly, ink, bricks, etc. These all are examples of material noun. Note should be there that articles such as a or an are not used before a material noun. So it means the can be used before material noun, but a or an cannot be used before it. Now let's move on to another type of nouns, which is collective noun. A collective noun is a group of similar. It is the name of a collection of things taken as a whole group. So any group of some similar things of people is known as a collective noun. For example, a group of people is known as crowd. A group of soldiers is known as army. A flock of sheep, a group of sheep is known as flock. And a group of ships is known as fleet. A group of girls or girls which are doing some particular thing are known, is known as bevy. Now let's move on to abstract noun. Abstract nouns are the words which give names to something intangible. Intangible means a thing which we cannot touch, but we can only feel it. So to find out abstract noun, we should remember FAQS. This FAQS is a short form of some words which help us to recognize what is the abstract noun in the given sentence. F stands for feelings, A stands for actions, Q stands for quality, and S for state. So feelings, actions, quality, or state. These things help us to recognize abstract noun in a sentence. Now there's another thing that abstract nouns are also made by adding suffixes. What are suffixes? These are the words added after root words. For example, happy plus ness. So happy is the root word, ness is the suffix. So happiness is the abstract noun. It is to be kept in mind that while adding suffixes, OR and ER should not be added to a verb. See, an abstract noun can be made with the help of a verb also. So we have to keep in mind that we should not add OR or ER in a verb to make it an abstract noun. Because OR and ER, when added to a verb, they make common noun instead of abstract noun. So this thing should be kept in mind. The examples you can see, act is a verb, plus OR becomes actor, and actor is a common noun, not an abstract noun. Similarly, drive is a verb, drive plus ER becomes driver, and it again is a common noun. Now making abstract nouns, let's make different abstract nouns with the word and suffixes. So the first word is friend. Friend plus ship suffix becomes friendship, which is an abstract noun. Similarly, attend plus ends. So attendance is an abstract noun. Difficult plus y suffix, difficulty is an abstract noun. King plus ship becomes kingship. Laugh plus stir becomes laughter. Child plus hood becomes childhood. And similarly, grow plus th becomes growth. So you must have just seen that abstract nouns can be made by adding suffixes also in the verb or a noun also. Now let's find different nouns in a sentence. Here are a few sentences. I will be reading the sentence and you have to find out the nouns in the sentence. So the first sentence is, the captain decided the team. So what is the noun here in the sentence? Captain and team. And they both are which type of noun? They both are common noun. In the second sentence, Rahul loves his home. So the noun here in the sentence are Rahul and home. So Rahul is which type of noun? A proper noun, because it's a name of a boy. And home? Home is a common noun. Now third sentence is, my mother bought oranges. So in this sentence, mother and oranges are nouns. Mother is which type of noun? Yes, a common noun. And oranges, it is also a common noun. The next is, the year has passed quickly. So what is the noun here in the sentence? Yes, year is the noun here. And which type of noun? A common noun. Next, honesty is the best policy. Now what is the noun in this sentence? Honesty and policy. So which type of noun is honesty? It's an abstract noun. Now sixth sentence, hatred spoils everything. So what is the noun here in the sentence? Hatred and everything. So hatred is an abstract noun and everything is a common noun. Seventh, the soldiers were awarded for their bravery. So what are the nouns here? Soldiers and bravery. So soldiers is the common noun and bravery is an abstract noun. Now the last sentence here is, wisdom is better than strength. So what is the noun here? Wisdom and strength. And these both are abstract nouns. So I hope that you must all have understood the different types of nouns. And if you have not understood and if you have any problem in it, you can write down in the comment box and you can like, share and subscribe the video. Thank you so much for watching the video.